What it is, what it could be. It is the kid, the goat, the young guy, Toby the Tyrant, and we are here with the ever anticipated Playroom series. Like I said, I was gonna make these breakdowns, so I'm happy to finally get into it with you all. I'm gonna be doing these breakdowns over park, rec, pro-am, 3v3 pro-am, 5v5 pro-am, just all the game modes pretty much, so that you guys will get more acquainted or familiar with some of the tips and tricks, the do's and don'ts of each said game mode. Let's get into this Playroom episode one right here. As you can see, this is the Sheriff Factory background going on right now. The Playroom episode one, that is my PSN, Toby the Tyrant right there. Today we are going over some 5v5 rec gameplay. So as you can see, I'm on my two-way slashing play. That's me in the left corner. We have Shy on ball, which is our center, a 7-1 paint defender. Our two guard is in the right corner, number 10. He is also a two-way slashing play. He is a shooting guard version of the build, though. Our three man is number 37 for the middle of the floor. He is a sharpshooting facilitator with more emphasis on his defense than his finishing. And then our four man is number 24 toward the right wing. He is a three-level scorer playing at the small forward position. But that is our lineup. Let's get right into it pretty much. Hold on. So play one, Shy is guarding the inbound. The inbound goes from the stretch center to the rich boy Q. He is their shooting guard. He's been running most of their offense today. He's an offensive threat. He drives immediately out of the corner. Easy dunk. So right here, the mistake that was made, you'll see a little bit later. We're gonna keep going with the playthrough, getting that offensive play right there, so we can get offense and defense in the same play. So let's get to the breakdown. Like I said, out of the corner, they're running a stretch center on the baseline inbound. He hits the corner man right there. They're pretty much their whole offense, Ridgeboy Q. So there should be a switch right there between our center and our shooting guard, just a full-on switch. Need to be communicated because the popping center, the stretch, rolls right to the wing past him. He gets that bump animation he wants, which knocks our two-way slashing play a little bit further off of him, giving him space to drive with that quick first step. So Shy should have switched right there, just a full-on switch. Shy could have picked up the baseline drive and Mark could have picked up the potential pop from the center. That's just keeping it simple. That's what should have happened right there, communication on a switch. So like I said, keeping the play rolling. This is our offensive possession right afterwards. I stop, I cross in front of Shy to let him know to go to the right side, as we already have our three level in the corner, but to keep the floor space with equilibrium, I tell him to go to the right. So this is about spacing. He's going toward the right side. RCR shooting guard, hit that wing cut toward the lane. My man is looking the other way. His man gets caught trying to play the previous three-point lane instead of the cutting lane. Tries to get that last second interception, but my needle threader works out. A little bit of luck getting a free dunk through this spacing. As you see, I dribble across that side. But getting into play number two, a full-on switch by Shy. Crosses by me. Just, it looks like a lot of scrambling, a lot of swarming, depending on where the ball is, just to keep them guessing on how to play about this. Outlet comes, slows down. Free three right there. Bang. So in the breakdown, you got the two-way slash and play mark on the ball. This is about activity. He gets a big body, has to full-on switch with Shy, our center, who had already dropped. Picks up ball. Mark gets caught jumping. I run out, try to get a passing lane deflection, as I know he's not going to take that shot as he's driving. Back on ball, Shy is defending the point guard pretty well. I help over just to show. Give him a little hesitation. I know he's going to go in the post. Help back down low on our two-way slash play against their stretch in the paint. He goes up with, it's 7%. He could have hit that, but that is just activity. Helping down, switching and whatnot. This is a play number three, easy offensive possession. So just a quick two. As you can see, I'm coming down on the right side of the floor. I see Shy in the corner on the left side. Our three levels already in the corner. This is a misdirection. Mark cuts, slids back out because they saw I hit them earlier with that cut for an easy two. I cross over from the middle of the floor back to the right side. They're bunched up on the left, but we are as well. So it was just, I mean, just rec play pretty much. Not really organized pro am. I cross back over. My man is stuck at the middle because he was leaning too far to the left side, thinking I was going to bunch up. Free paint drive right there. Almost got pinched because Shy cut a little bit too prematurely. But I still get that easy open lane. You see it split open. Mike begins to wrap to try to space the floor back out, leaving it two on each side and a three in the middle dunk, keeping it to five out. But that's that misdirection. I could have hit Mike on the cross. Play number four. You got QR three level on the ball. Shy recovers. Mike had to show. Gets back on his man in time. I'm back in the right corner. They perform a wrap. Loose ball foul on our two-way right there. So to avoid this, pretty much should have happened right here. Me and Mike are in the background. As we know, Q's picking up ball. We're trying to be active, trying to show a little bit, stay active, keep them guessing. Shy gets caught, bumped, recovers. The guy tries to kick it. As Mike showed, gets back in time. I'm lost a little bit, but as I'm recovering, I make sure I stay in the passing lane in case they try to hit my man, so I can get at least a deflection. A wrap occurs. Like I said, Mark gets caught running through. So right here, what happened was Q hugged the ball handler as soon as he got the ball. And as the wrap occurs, he hugs up on him again, gets all skinny right there next to him as Mark is getting caught on that backwards bump screen and the wrap is occurring. So the second hug up by Q right here, instead of hugging up, he should have dropped to the corner to pick up that wrap so Mark could have at least recovered around that screen to pick up the nearest man, which would have been number five, which as you can see, he's right there to cover number five in case he tries to pull if Q had dropped down. So to avoid that foul, which gives him just a free throw pretty much and the possession back, Q, as the ball swings to his man, hugs up the first time, which was fine, but as the wrap occurs, he needs to drop off, but he hugs up again right there. Hugs up as the man gets the ball. The wrap begins as he dexed. Q hugs up instantly as the wrap is occurring, leaving Mark to try to shoot across from the middle, the top of the free throw arch to the corner, trying to get back as they set another screen in that corner. So to avoid that, just a full-on switch right there by Q to drop back into that passing lane and let Mark pick up the ball would have been fine. Play number five. Ball coming down, a switch happens, another switch happens as the screen comes. Shy's on ball, I'm showing, I help completely. Passing lane, steal, kick out, on the fast break, wrap, green the midi. So right here what happens is, the two guard is yet again bringing the ball down the floor, number zero. Mark is in the middle of the floor and Mike is on the left, so he just says he's gonna full up pick up ball handler because ball handler went left. Mike's on ball. They do a screen. Shy picks up the handoff of the player. Shy's on ball. Mike dropped with the center. Follows the center back out to the three-point line. I'm hedging over because my man's in the paint trying to get a bucket. I go from the baiting on the passing lane to full-on helping right there because I want to prevent that two. It was a bad decision by me. Could have resulted in three, as you see my man dropped right down into that corner. Mark went straight to his man. That was a free three. It looks like I'm baiting from the passing lane, but in honesty, I was just full on helping right there. I wasn't really baiting a pass. I saw the blow by happening. He didn't go to my man, which is lucky for us. He went to the corner man, easy pickings, kick out, 3-2. If he would have made the right decision and went to the right wing where my man was, it would have been a three pointer, possibly. Which would have been my fault. But then, let's get on to play number six. Mike's on ball, gets a poke. Kicks it out. Hit the wrap. Green up. So right here, what happens is, I'm on ball in the corner. Mike gets hit with a screen right there up top. Well, not really a screen, but the center's just running into him so that they can get that open three. Mike recovers, however, gets a poke, picks up the ball. Their center instantly bumps Mike, try to prevent the fast break by a team time. We got familiarity right here. I know where my teammates are going to go, and they know exactly how I'm running this. We did not communicate anything about this, but it was just adjustments. I drive, as you can see, Q, number 24, is coming down the middle, but he stops and goes back to the three-point line. Our corner man, Mark, is going straight to the corner, and Chai, who was also cutting, decides to wrap instead. We didn't communicate any of this. It just so happened to work out perfectly for us. As you can see, like I said, corner man up top three, Shy wrapping into the corner and me into the paint. I know Shy is going into that corner automatically, and he greens that 8 out of 10 times, sometimes 9 out of 10, you never know. But he was on fire this game. I think he finished 10 for 11 and 1 for 1 from the 3-point line as a 7-1 paint defender. They had nothing for him. So as you see the spacing, we got me in the paint, corner man up top, and Mike comes in at the last second on the right hash, Shy in the corner. We still have pretty much that 5-out type of spread and spacing to the floor. I guess 4-out at this point because I'm in the paint. But if he would have missed and I got the offensive rebound, I would have dribbled it back out and we would have had a 5-out. But that is episode 1 of the Playroom. Thank you for tuning in. Remember to hit that like button if you enjoyed. Subscribe if you haven't yet. Leave a comment if you have any suggestions on how you want me to do this. If you want me to do different game modes, or if you want to send something in you want me to break down, just leave a comment. Anything's appreciated. Turn on those notifications. Share with everyone you know that plays 2K, or any people you know that make YouTube videos or breakdowns. But like I said, thank you for tuning in. I'm going to be coming out with more videos, breakdowns, mixtapes, build videos, and all that. Thank you for tuning in. I am Toby, and I am out. Hope you enjoyed.